Namaste everyone, Anu Chabra here. Today I'll be showing you how efficiently I'm using my terrace and especially the section where I have kept my creepers. So this is the section, the inside of this room I have kept all my composting things. So this mesh of the room, I'm using it as a trellis for my creepers to grow. Okay, so this side, if you see, the wall is there. So I've taken the support of the wall. So all the creepers, I have had the bamboo sticks so that the creeper gets a support from the very beginning. And then later these bamboos have been tied with a string of cloth. So all this is a creeper variety. And in, with this, I have kept few floral plants so that pollination is also a must. As I every time I keep telling, when we want to grow vegetables, we cannot grow until unless we have a proper balance of environment, like we have to call pollinators. So for that, we have to have flowers around that. Now I'll tell you the trellis I have made with the old cloth. So it's a very simple, any of you can make it, but still a few of you people have asked me to make a small video on this. So I'm trying to show you, to just have a look. So any old cloth you take and you decide the area, how much area you want to cover for the trellis, because these climbers are going to be you can say run on those trellis. As every time I tell that climbers, we have to stop it after some height, approximately 5.5 to 6 feet height, then we have to train it horizontally. So you have to make sure that your trellis should be approximately 6 and a half feet, at the height of 6 and a half feet. Don't make it too high, because we don't want our plants to run that much height, because the energy of the plant, the creepers, will keep on decreasing as it grows tall. So 5.5 to 6 feet is ideal, so don't go beyond that. So now what I have done, I've just cut thin strips from my any cloth or dupatta or whatever you have, old sari or bed sheet, whatever, cut it into thin strips and decide the length, how much long you want your trellis should be. So I have taken one end this mesh, the other end I have taken the shade of my iron bar. Okay, so this is a constant length, so approximately you can say it's 8 and a half feet the length, but the height is not more than 6.5 feet. Okay, this I'm talking, this should not be at too much height. This you have to stop it maximum 6.5 to 7 feet. Now the strips what you have cut, first you make all the vertical, tie all the verticals. Suppose from there I have started and it will go till there. The next, so in between you can have 1 to 2 inches gap. Now once all the strips you have tied vertically, now we have to start making the horizontal mesh. Okay, now how to do that horizontal mesh? You just take another string, tie on the vertical string whatever you have done, just done it. Now just twist it. I have taken from here, you take it out here, you see here, just twisting it, no need to give knot. Okay, and then pull it. Now the second one, just take it out here and how much ever you want to make it tight, you pull it. Like that you keep twisting and make sure the vertical and horizontal ones, they are really tight, intact. Okay, so if the mesh is really intact, so the creepers, when it will climb on this, they, it will not droop. So it should be a really nice thing. One more thing what I want to tell you is, whenever you make a string, so in between you have seen I have put knots. Okay, so what happens when we just take a strip of a cloth, it keeps unraveling, the threads keep on coming out. So we don't have that much time and patience to sit and stitch all the two edges. So better at certain interval you just put a knot. If this way, at certain interval, if you see closely, I have put knots every 4 to 5 inches to each and every string. Then what happens, even if the cloth starts unraveling, it will get stuck here. So the whole thread will not come out. After certain interval, it will be intact. So this way, you have to tie horizontally in case it is little extra. So a few extras are there, but I have not cut them. You can see here, I have just left it, and those strings I have attached again to my bamboo sticks. So what happens, as and when the plant is growing, immediately it comes in contact with this string and automatically it will go to this horizontal trellis. Now it is up to you. I had cloth, because lockdown is there, I don't want to go out and buy some wires, mesh or something. Otherwise, you can use the telephone wires, your iron wires, or any other thing, whatever you have in your house, the best use of it. I wanted to recycle this old cloth, so I have done that. So whatever you feel like, do it. But if you give a proper trellis and a support to the creepers, so the concentration of all the creepers will be in giving you nice fruits. Otherwise, what happens, if they'll shake too much when too much of wind or rain is there, the concentration of the plant goes in keeping itself alive, because it's always in the danger zone, you can say, that I might die. So the full focus is on holding here and there the creeper, the tendrils and all. They'll keep searching for the support, so concentration will only be in the process of survival. It won't be in fruiting and flowering. So as and when, whenever you see it's a creeper variety, from the very beginning only we have to give support. Some people, they do a mistake that they, as the plant grows, they just tie a thread with the stem and then they tie the thread somewhere far. So in that case, the food pipe and the water pipe, the xylem phloem of the stem gets ruptured, and even if the plant is growing, it's not getting proper nutrition in the form of water and you can say other food. So the fruit, the quality of the fruit what we are going to get from that plant will not be that good as you have expected from that. So make sure whenever you are growing a creeper variety, give a very firm support from the very beginning. Even if it this is little thinner, if you have space, you can go for a little thicker support also. That is also more better. So make sure never grow any creeper variety without any support, and restrict their height at some point, 6.5 to 7 feet, and grow them horizontally to have maximum output from the plant whatever you are growing. So I hope the concept is clear. In case any doubts are there, you can write in the comment section. So thank you for joining me. Keep watching. Something new is yet to come. Thank you.